Dick Rochfort here, M350, Piper M350 Mirage, 8 Mike, and we want to talk a little bit about environmental systems. Just as in general, we have essentially two environmental systems. There's the upper plenum, the blowers, that are associated with a low and high fan here. And, of course, the air conditioner is on that upper plenum as well. And that's a recirculatory system only. The air comes in under the back seats, those vents under their aft seats. And fans bring that air across the evaporators for the AC system, although we're not running AC because it's minus 7C outside. And then bring that air to the WEMAX, or these little eyeballs that have a closing vent, just like on commercial aircraft. And that's it. So the only thing this system will deliver to each passenger seat through the eyeball WEMAX is ambient air from under the back seat, and or ambient air that's cooled with the AC system. And it's an automotive style system. It's works pretty good, but it will only give you about a 20 degree delta over outside air temperature. And I say only, that's plenty. But in really hot areas like Western Australia in the summertime, it can be woefully inadequate. And so pilots will use foil window covers. But keep in mind, those are only for the ground. Those have to be removed prior to flight. And I personally own a small portable 28-volt air conditioner that I run during cockpit procedures training exercises, because it gets pretty hot. And that's a third system, but it doesn't come with the airplane. So that's the upper system. The lower system are a couple of vents, and they're, as the name implies, they're down here against the wall of the sidewalls of the aircraft. There are only five of those vents. There's two up front. There's two in opposite the walls on the middle seats, and then only one on the aft seats, and that's on the right-hand wall. Now then, that brings bleed air into the cabin, which, as the name implies, is adiabatically heated. But it also has with it an aux cabin heater and a fan. And the fan comes on with the aux cabin heater, or you could bring the fan on. You have to bring the fan on first, sorry. And then the aux cabin heater. And that brings warm air through these adjustable louvers down here on this, on these sidewall vents. Alternatively, you must pull the cabin temp hot stalk out. And alternatively, you can open the defrost and bring warm air. And this is, of course, very dry air because it's a, you know, external air at high altitude. And that'll bring air through these vents up here. And then to clear the windshield, of course, we have heated windshield, and we have high, and we have low. Now I'm going to turn this off because we really don't need it today. So we can turn off the aux heat, leave on the vent fog fan, or not. Push the stalk back in and push this cabin heat here is the heat exchanger on the right side of the engine that puts bleed air through a heat exchanger on the right exhaust muff. That system is in the piston airplane is marginal for rear seat passengers, so you must have all the heat on and the defrost in to get enough heat to the back. Probably want to tell the passengers not to block the vents with their feet or with bags. And then and for us, we have to really lift our feet up onto the rudder pedals away from the vent. And then we want to open the WEMAC and get some cool air going up here, and then advise the passengers to close their eyeballs, well, the WEMACs. And then you get some good heat. It wouldn't hurt either to put a nice toasty warm blanket in the back for the passengers back there, particularly in the winter. This is Dick Rochfort. Fly safely. Train often.